you throw a ball, the dynamics of that, how that ball moves, is what we call classical, because it's a very big object. It's something we can see with our eyes, something we interact with in our own lives. But as things start to get smaller and smaller and smaller, they obey a different kind of dynamics. They have something called wave-particle duality. So they also kind of behave like a ball, but they also behave like a wave. So there's a probability of them being in a certain position or moving at a certain speed, and they can spread themselves out across all these probabilities until we measure it. And when we measure it, that's when we know its true quantum state. We know that the universe is made up of things like atoms and electrons and protons, things that behave quantum mechanically. And over the last 20 years, we've gotten very good at controlling the states, the actual quantum states. And as we start to control these quantum states, we can start to use them to do things for computing, for sensing. So specifically, I work with quantum computers and quantum networks where we control these devices, we call them qubits, and we control them to solve useful problems like optimization or chemistry simulation, and I develop algorithms to do that. My research right now is doing something that's never been done before, and I'm exploring completely new territory with an awesome group of people. We are working to use artificial intelligence to control quantum networks and to control quantum computers. And this is an entirely new space. And I think that's what's making me most excited is these theories, these things I've been trying to develop are going to be able to have a practical use. What I envision as the future, and this is like what I get really excited about, is we talk about having one quantum computer, but if we have two quantum computers and these quantum computers can be connected together and you can start to develop these quantum data centers, it's a way to get more qubits. It's a way to run algorithms in parallel, and I envision quantum data centers becoming the future.